Professor Dave here, let's talk about hydrogenation of alkynes.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So when we first talked about addition reactions, one of the first things that we talked about was hydrogenation, and we learned about some different ways that hydrogen atoms can add to a pi bond. And so the first way that we looked at to do that was just simple hydrogen over palladium. We saw that two hydrogen atoms would add syn to the alkene, and we saw that that was an example of hydrogenation. And so for all the addition reactions, we looked at all kinds of ways that we can do chemistry with alkenes. But sometimes we want to hydrogenate alkynes. And so there's a few different ways to do this. Now, the first is just the example we just said. The same way that we can go from the alkene to the alkane with hydrogen over a palladium or some similar metal is gonna hold here. It's gonna do the same thing, right? Hydrogens can attach to, can interact with any pi bond, and so we're gonna have that go from the alkyne all the way to the alkane. So it's not going to be able to stop at the alkene functional group level. It's going to continue because we know that hydrogen will interact with alkenes as well. So we're going to go from the alkyne all the way to the alkane. So if you ever see an alkyne in these conditions, we know that we're just going to get rid of all the pi bonds. We're going to go straight to the fully saturated alkane. But there may be instances, especially in synthesis, right, for a synthetic technique, we may want to go just one step down. We may want to go from the alkyne and stop at the alkene and not go all the way to the alkane. And so there's a couple ways to do this. The first one looks like this. This is a situation, right? This is called Lindler's catalyst. And so what it is it's hydrogen and it's a metal, it's palladium, but it's been poisoned. And so what happens is that actually limits its ability to hydrogenate. It is only able to hydrogenate alkynes and not alkenes. And so it's going to be able to interact with this alkyne and produce an alkene, but it is specifically going to produce the Z-alkene, right? So remember, when we have an alkene, we can have two different kinds of stereochemistry. We could have an E or a Z-alkene. And if you remember my tutorial on this, we talked about how to use the Kahn-Ingold-Prelog convention to assess whether an alkene is E or Z. And so in this case, it's Z because, if you remember, Z-zame-zide, right? So these groups are on the same side of the plane containing the double bond. So this is a Z-alkene. And so when we see these conditions, now there are a few variations. You may see it written a few different ways. Oftentimes, you will just see the words Lindler's catalyst or simply Lindler. And so what this is telling us is we know we're going from the alkyne to the Z-alkene. Okay, so that is one thing that we could do very deliberately in a synthetic pathway if we have an alkyne and we want to get a Z-alkene to then do some other chemistry. Now, obviously, if we have a way to get the Z-alkene, we want to have a way to get the E-alkene as well, depending on what we're trying to do in our synthetic pathway. And so there's another way, and let's start with that same alkyne one more time. And what we're seeing is that if we have this situation, we could see it like this with lithium and ethylamine and ammonium chloride. An alternate way that you will commonly see is sodium and ammonia. So really the key here is one of these metals, lithium or sodium, one of those alkali metals that is going to do this chemistry. It is going to, again, in a limited way, it's not going to be able to hydrogenate the alkene. So it is going to stop at the alkene functional group level. It's going to take the alkyne and it's going to go to the alkene, but it will specifically go to the E-alkene. Okay, so these are three things that we want to remember. In terms of hydrogenation of alkynes, we have three ways that we can go. We can go all the way to the alkane with simple hydrogenation over palladium metal, or we can use Lindler's catalyst and go to the Z-alkene, or we can use one of these two situations and go to the E-alkene. So let's put this into context. Let's say we're looking at this molecule, this alkyne, and we are going to attempt three different kinds of hydrogenation. Let's make sure that we understand what the product is going to be in each of these cases. So we've got an alkyne. This is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5-carbon alkyne. Really quickly, a lot of times students encounter some confusion when depicting alkynes. It does have to have this geometry, and these are carbons right there. Remember that carbons participating in triple bonds are sp hybridized and therefore exhibit linear geometry. So this is the right way to draw that, right? We can't have alkynes in a zigzag fashion, because that doesn't depict the geometry accurately. We do have a carbon here, and then 2 and 3 are triple bound, and then 4 and 5. So this is a 5-car, this is 2-pentyne would be the IUPAC name. And now let's say that we're going to do these three different kinds of hydrogenation here. Let's say we do hydrogenation over palladium. And so what are we going to get? Well, we know that when we do this, we are not able to stop at the alkene, right? This is going to hydrogenate. It's going to react with both of those pi bonds, and we're going to go all the way to the alkane. So we're going to get a 5-carbon alkane. We're going to get pentane right there. So that's what's going to happen if we use those conditions for hydrogenation. Now let's look over here. Now, what is this? We need to be able to look at conditions and, as best we can, sort of memorize what they do so that on a test we know what to draw. And we should recognize that this is Lindler's catalyst, or once again, we might just see Lindler right there. And what we want to associate in our minds is that Lindler's catalyst is always going to stop at the alkene, and it specifically will stop at the Z alkene. So we're going to get a 5-carbon alkene. Right, so we're going to have a 1, 2, right, this is going to be, and so 1, 2, 3, right, it's going to connect these two, but they're going to be Z, it's going to be a Z alkene, right? So this necessarily has to have this orientation. We need to have these alkyl groups projecting in the same direction, because Z same side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is a 5-carbon alkene. This is in the correct position, and we also have the correct stereochemistry at that location. And so we've got the Z alkene. That leaves our last situation here. We could have these conditions, or once again, you may often see sodium and ammonia. And so when you see something like that, again, we're looking for this alkali metal there, lithium or sodium. That's what's going to be doing the chemistry. And we are going to get, again, the 5-carbon alkene, but now we are going to get the E alkene. Right, so the E alkene has the alkyl groups projecting in opposite directions. So whereas over here, right, these are the hydrogens right there. Those are the ones that got on there. So the hydrogens added to the same side. We've got Z same side. Over here, we added these two opposite sides, okay? So we've got the alkane, we've got the Z alkene, and we've got the E alkene. And hopefully that helps us understand these three different sets of conditions for hydrogenation of alkynes. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.